Exploit Exercises Protostar offers a Linux image with several challenges to learn binary exploitation. But a lot has changed over the years, and if you compile these challenges yourself on a modern system, it's not as easy anymore. I already showed you that in previous videos about the stack challenge. I had to make a 3-part video series to explain how we can still do it, and that also only on 32-bit. So if you are just starting out, make sure that you use the Linux image that you can download here and don't compile the stuff yourself. Otherwise, all the tutorials about it won't work. And now for this video, let's continue with some other challenge. We compile them on a current Ubuntu version without any compiler flags and see what we get. Obviously, the rules of the game that is hacking are that maybe there are techniques I just don't know about. I don't really know the edge cases in exploitation, I mostly know the general techniques, and I think I have some reasonable amount of creativity, but I don't know everything. So it's likely that there are people out there that could exploit it. In that case, I'd love to see a POC for that. That being said, let's continue with format0. So what is this challenge about? The attacker can pass in an argument. That argument is then being passed as the string variable to the format parameter of sprintf. So we can inject stuff like %d or %s. It's also vulnerable to a buffer overflow because sprintf does not print to the console to stdout like regular printf, but prints or stores the formatted string in buffer. And the buffer is only 64 bytes long. Now, when you attack this on the VM that you can download here that has these challenges pre-compiled, the target variable would be placed after the buffer so that you can overflow the buffer and write into target. And then you have target modified, and when you make it so that it's overflown with hex dead beef, you pass this check. So enter 64 characters and dead beef and you won. But the challenge here also said try it with less than 10 bytes, and you would do that by abusing format string modifiers that would stretch the formatted output to, for example, 64 characters, and then you can simply enter hex dead beef afterwards. So for example, %64d would output a number with up to 64 character padding, and so 64 characters plus hex dead beef are written into the buffer and you win. Well, is that still possible? First, we have to install GCC and GDB on this fresh machine. And I'm also going ahead to install PEDA, a GDB extension that makes things look nicer. So let's start with a simple buffer overflow example. But first, let's set a breakpoint in vuln before we compare dead beef. Then let's start the binary and pass in an input that is much larger than 64 bytes. Okay. So we hit the breakpoint and it compares EAX with dead beef, but EAX is 0. How can that be? Didn't we overflow the stack? Well, we certainly did. The issue is that the target variable doesn't come after the buffer. It is before. So we can write as much data as we want, we won't overwrite target. You can also see this here. EAX is loaded from base pointer minus hex 54, while the address for the string is loaded from base pointer minus hex 50. So it's located after target. Well, does this mean it's not exploitable? So if you're familiar with format string exploits, you also know that you can write data with it by abusing the %n modifier, which writes the amount of already printed characters to an address on the stack. And we can overflow the stack, so we could place an address there and then carefully construct the number of characters printed before such that it writes dead beef to an address. And so we could write to target and win that way, right? But ASLR is our problem. Let me add a printf to the code to print the address of target. %target returns the reference of a variable, so that's the address. And when we compile it and run it in a nice while true loop, you see how crazy the address of target changes. Target is a local variable, so it's located on the stack. So this is also a stack address. But how much does it change? It always starts with hex 7FF and ends in a C. And this one nibble here only appears to be C, D, E, or F. That's a huge number. It's over 1 billion. But maybe in this case, actually doable. Just take some time, maybe a day or so. I'd just like to refer to the previous 3-part video where we brute-forced a 3-byte stack cookie that was roughly 16 million possible options, and so here is in reach, I would say. At least for a very small binary like this, the execution speed is quite fast. Let's see how it looks like on 32-bit. We have to install GCC multilib to do that, and then we can compile it with -m32. When we execute it a few times, you can see that it obviously has less randomness than on 64-bit. It's only 2 full bytes and then again a nibble. That's about 1 million attempts to hit it, so definitely even more in reach. But of course, it's only feasible if you can do millions of attempts reasonably fast, for example locally. If this were an application that takes longer to start or a remote service, then that would probably mean you couldn't really do it. How to create a format string exploit and how that exactly works with %n you can watch in multiple other videos that I've done, but there is one additional trick that comes to mind we could look out for. So to write with %n, we expect the target address to be on the stack. In a classic format string exploit, you would use your input that is maybe also placed on the stack and reference itself. But nobody says it has to be an address you place there. The stack is full of values. Maybe you get lucky. If we look on a stack when we are at the dead beef compare in the execution flow, you can see a lot of stack addresses. And so these would always be valid stack addresses, even with ASLR. Now if one of those would magically point to target, then we could just reuse it. We could just reference that address. But if we check the address we know of target, we can see that it doesn't show up. Oh well. But you see how creative you can get with the exploitation. We could have been lucky. But let's actually continue this train of thought. Okay, we don't have the full target address on the stack, but we do have a lot of other stack addresses. And we have an overflow, so we can overflow into the addresses and just overwrite some low bytes and keep the whole front. Let's add another printf to print the target value and print the resulting formatted buffer, and then let's play with that. Here you can see the sprintf formatted result. Let's try to find AAABBB on the stack by consuming values from the stack with some format modifiers. I want to find the offset where in the stack this value is placed, and we can explore that with, for example, %lx and the dollar notation. So at stack offset 1, it's not. At offset 2, it's not. At offset 3, it's not, and so forth. But at offset 9, we now printed the hex value of our input. Now let's look at the stack layout for a nice stack address we could partially overwrite. Okay, so down here is one. Let's see what offset it has. Let's keep going. There it is, at offset 19. Which also means from the start at offset 9 to offset 19 we have 10 grooves of 8 bytes, so 80 bytes to fill and reach this value. We can achieve that with a format string that pads a number to 80 bytes and then some input to prove that we overflow. And when we now execute it, we see that the end of our address that got printed by our 19LX got overwritten with ace. If you paid attention, you saw that target is always at an offset with a C. So we can choose some input that ends with a C as well to overwrite it. For example, L, that is hex 4C. Let's execute that now. You can compare what address we got now through the overwrite with L and what target really was. You see that often it's not the same, but eventually it will match. And so if we replace the %lx to print a 8-byte hex value to %n, then we will write to that address. So now we are writing the amount of printed characters, 81, because 80 plus the single L, to this address, and maybe at some point we hit target. Let's keep trying. Boom, there we hit target. We wrote hex 5.1 to it, which is 81 in decimal. And that works fairly reliably. We can try those few attempts by hand. And I think that's awesome. Unfortunately, it's not quite the solution because target has to be dead beef, and that's 3 billion in decimal. So with this technique, we would have to first print 3 billion characters before we can do percentage n, and that's not possible. Anyway, I think you can see how much exploitation can become a puzzle that you slowly try to piece together. In the end, I didn't manage to solve it, but exploring this was really fun. I really wonder if somebody is able to make a semi-reliable exploit for this.